waleta matamsanqa. Yabo!
One of the most beautiful cities in the world.
A wonderful place to live, to work, and a wonderful place to play.
Cultural beauty as well as environmental beauty.
The top 10 destinations in the world to come visit.
Beautiful beaches, our beautiful mountains, but most of all, our beautiful people.
You can see every nationality on the planet here.
Most of the people speak about 11 different languages.
Obviously the most beautiful in Africa.
Cape Town.
Cape Town.
Cape Town.
Cape Town.
Cape Town.
Cape Town.
Marhaba to Cape Town.
It's a very big city. We have 3.6 million people, 3.6 million population. It's not that big looking at other cities across the world of 10 million and 7 million people and so on. But I think Cape Town consists of all the racial groups you can find on Mother Earth. I'm very happy to have this opportunity to speak to the people of Kuwait. We really would like to welcome you in our city, in our province, and in our country.
Cape Town at the southern point of Africa is certainly one of the beautiful cities of the world. There's a physical beauty about this place which is reflected in the mountain, which is reflected in the rugged sea coastal area. And those are clearly aspects which attracted the very early settlers from the north to this place, which was already home to a number of indigenous communities. So Cape Town is a beautiful place. It has an incredibly diverse community made up of many types of people, immigrants and locals, indigenous people. And over the recent past, we've also welcomed the world. Oh,
Ngosisikeleli Afrika maliphakanyisa uphondo lwayo.
Ngosisikeleli Afrika maliphakanyisa uphondo lwayo. Yizwa nemithandazo yethu. Ngosisikelela thina lusapho lwayo.
South Africa.
South Africa.
One of the most spiritual song of South Africa. Marimba music is the music that is performed by the group of people. You can't perform marimba as an individual because in that marimba you must have the bass, you must have all the like alto and sopranos, but it's a natural, it's a made, like a, what can I say, like a, it's from the tree. Special, especially from the world people, from the tourists, especially from overseas. They've got a different sounds because each and every producer of South Africa can just produce about the birds of South Africa, the elephants of South Africa, the rivers of South Africa, everything. And then they can combine that thing in one thing, and then they came with the one special thing. Marimba.
Marimba
is marimba.
Can I help you?
Okay.
Alright, hello. It's Bruce here. Well, I've just come back from taking some photographs and I entered my office and this guy from Kuwait, working in Kuwait, he wants photographs that I've taken now of this stadium. the last 3 years. That's going to be quite something to find, but I'll help him as much as I can.
There are a number of challenges around the stadium, about situating the stadium. A number of the Greenpoint ratepayers associations weren't too happy with having a stadium of that nature there, and they were thinking of this ugly monstrosity being built. But I think the shape and the design of the stadium has come out to be a winner in Cape Town. You know, Dr. Danny Jordan and the Secretary General of FIFA, Mr. Jerome Valk, mentioned some time ago when we took the stadium over, when it was practically finished, they said that this is going to be, you're going to know Cape Town for the sea, the mountain and its stadium. You know, and I think it's going to be an iconic site in Cape Town.
Hi there. I'm a photographer. I'm employed by the City of Cape Town to document their big projects and their photography. I photograph everything from mayoral visits, state visits, constructions such as the Cape Town Stadium. Do roads, bridges. My favorite bit of photography is aerial photography. This Cape Town Stadium project took 3 years. My pictures, it's from start to finish. I've been taking photographs of many projects in Cape Town, and one of the biggest projects that I've ever done is the stadium, the Cape Town Stadium. One of the favorite parts of the stadium was viewing it from the air, such as this photograph I took before the stadium was built. You might be able to see over here there's no stadium. Now the Cape Town Stadium has been built there on the Metropolitan Golf Course site, and on the left hand side of the picture lies Cape Town with Table Mountain. Construction began within a few days. Vehicles moved on site, started preparing the earth, digging the trenches for the columns, the 72 columns to be built. That was an aerial photograph. This photograph I took from a tower nearby. No, in fact, I correct myself, this is also from a helicopter. Very low altitude aerial photograph showing the volume of trenches that had been dug. And I'll open a picture, 1st of October 2007, I took this photograph. This is early stages. There you can see the pitch on the right, and this is a concrete pumping machine putting concrete in the first deck level. Steel reinforcing, the yellow looks like high tension cables that were going around the stadium. May 14th, 2008, that's a view from the one of the old light towers that illuminated the old stadium. That's a view showing the podium block and then the 72 columns. It looks like all 72 columns were already constructed by this time. Here's a view showing Greenpoint, the Greenpoint Common, the stadium. They're busy putting the compression ring on the stadium here. The compression ring that's being supported, that's the support being held up by 72 columns. The compression ring supports the glass roof. Of course, I forgot to mention that this upper compression ring was in fact constructed in Kuwait, and then it was brought to Cape Town by ship. So the outer construction, the outer compression ring is fixed on top of the columns, the 72 columns. The compression ring is joined and the cables are being lifted. It's a huge achievement when those pins were going in. Every cable had a pin at the top that had to be pinned to the compression component, to the compression ring component.
Was built in 32 months. It was designed by a German architect. Over the months, it has taken the shape of a perlemann or an abalone, which is a seashell under the sea. It's got a grey and pinkish tinge. Now, the architect says that special features of the stadium are the fact that nobody has ever more than 50 meters from the pitch. Very, very close, and that's why it's high. So you get very much more involvement in the game. It has 68,000 seats, one of the biggest ones in South Africa. And it also is the only stadium in Africa which has a glass roof, completely made of glass. And some of the technology comes from Germany, some from the Far East. And it's very much a mixture of architecture. You can see all around the stadium the 360 lights which will light up the stadium. They call it the Ring of Fire because there's so many lights here in the stadium. Above that you have the glass. The whole roof is made of glass all the way around, but there's no middle section, so it's open in the middle, and the glass is only 16 millimeters thick, but it's very strong. And people can walk up there without any problems whatsoever.
Well, Cape Town is probably the most incredible city in the whole of the world. I had many choices where I could go and live, and I chose to come here because it just has everything. It has the most amazing weather, although at this time of year we don't see that. It has some of the most beautiful buildings. The people themselves are fun and lively.
Soccer fields to cheer our team. We have our vuvuzelas and wear our makarabas, our plastic hats. We blow the vuvuzelas to cheer our team and sing songs and we paint our faces. The hat used to be worn by the people who used to work in the mines back in the days. But now we took it and we made it look a little bit more nicer than it was. We painted it with nice colors and put in some pictures, adding some extra tins on it to make it look nice.
Hello, Kuwait people.
Hello, people of Kuwait. Please come to South Africa. We're looking forward to having you here.
All the people in Kuwait, you must come to Cape Town and come and see the vast differences of this big city. Give you freedom.
fire. Give you reason, take you higher. See the champions, take the field down. Unify us, make us feel proud. In the streets.
10th of June 2009, it's my very first panoramic aerial photograph showing the project. This photograph went all over the world. It was basically the introductory photograph that probably everybody in the world saw that Cape Town was in fact making this stadium here. 22nd of October 2009, this was the first photograph I took showing the test of the lights in the stadium, when the lights started coming on. This photograph I took showing the stadium under construction from the port control building in the harbour, the Cape Town Harbour. That was also one of the first pictures of the stadium. This photograph was one of the first photographs of the stadium at night. Key handover happened on the 14th of December. The mayor of the City of Cape Town, Executive Mayor Alderman Plato, he handed the keys. He in fact received the keys from the construction company to take over the stadium, and we had a small ceremony and released a few balloons.
There are 360 lights around the roof of the stadium to light up the pitch. So at night time, with the material on the outside, it looks like a pink lantern almost, like a pink shellfish floating in the water. That is the feeling that it gives you. Yes, we're looking forward here to welcoming people from Kuwait, the Kuwaitis. We have lots to show them here in Cape Town. Apart from the football, we have Table Mountain right next door to the stadium. Robben Island, where Mandela was imprisoned. We have the waterfront, which is world famous now. The wine lands, where beautiful grapes are grown and some of the best wine in the whole world. We have the Cape Point Nature Reserve. And we have beautiful nature, lovely white beaches all around the peninsula here.
Welcome to Cape Town. Ahalan wa salan.
Cape Town, it's great excitement, it's bringing people together, it's building a cohesive identity for the world to see Cape Town, and that it's not such a bad place after all. So the World Cup's bringing a feeling of excitement and a feeling of diverse excitement.
About this clothes,
yeah.
This is a traditional African clothing. Did you see the skirt? and this one they call the apron. We made them here. We made it in the right in the premises. This is a called African clothing. This hat is made in South Africa. It's a traditional Zulu. It's a Zulu people wear this hat.
A very safe and secure place. It's a very beautiful city. I repeat myself to say one of the most beautiful on Mother Earth. If you come and visit Cape Town, you will have a time of your life.